This is part one of Easy Way to Find Trig Functions of Special Angles, and we do the following seven problems on this video. In this video, I'm going to show you an easy way to find the trig functions of the special angles. So I think of there as being three cases of the special angles. The ones that are on the quadrants 90 degrees apart, so 0, 90, 180, 270, 360, etc. in degrees, and it could be plus or minus. Then there's the 45 degree angle, so plus or minus 45 degree angles, and then you could keep adding 90 degrees to get all the rest of those. And the 30, 60, 90 triangle, so plus or minus 30 or 60 degrees, or plus or minus 120, 150 degrees. So you've noticed I'm not listing the ones in green here, which are, you know, at the 90 degree. All right, so let's start off with the first set of special angles. All right, so here's sort of the picture of where the special angles would be. Imagine a unit circle, if you will, in other words, a radius of 1. Then I've got these four points, 1, 0, 0, 1, negative 1, 0, and 0, negative 1. So let's say I wanted to find what the cosine of 90 degrees is. So I have to know where 90 degrees, it's up here. And so at 90 degrees, just keep in mind the order pair is 0, 1, and the radius is 1 for all of these. The cosine is defined as just x over r. So x in this order pair is 0, and r is 1. So the cosine of 90 degrees is 0. Now let's go ahead and do the tangent of 90 degrees. So the tangent we think of as y over x. So again, I'm looking at the same order pair 0, 1. Y is 1 and x is 0, so it's 1 over 0, but remember what we write, we don't leave an answer with a 0 in the denominator, we would write that that's undefined. So that's how we would do it for 90 degrees, and you do exactly the same thing for any order pair that, you know, lands right on the x or y axis like this. And of course, I'm not writing down the reciprocal identities, the secant, cosecant, and cotangent, but those are just the reciprocals of each of these fractions. All right, what if you were asked to find the sine of 630 degrees? First of all, that's over 360 degrees, so we want to subtract 360 to see if we get a number in between 0 and 360. So this would be 270 degrees, and then you think, well, where's 270 degrees? It's all the way over here, and that's the ordered pair, 0, negative 1. Remember, the radius is always 1, so the sine is the y over r, negative 1 over 1, and the answer would be negative 1. So there's an example of something over 360 degrees. Same goes if something is negative, you would have to find where it is between 0 and 360, so it'd be easy to plug in the x, y, or r from one of those four ordered pairs. So that's how to deal with the first set of special angles. The second kind of special angle is the 45 degree angle. And I'm not going over how we get this triangle, that's in a separate video, but in a 45 degree angle, in a right triangle, 45 degrees is one angle, then 45 is the other angle. So both of the legs are 1, and from the Pythagorean theorem, we get the hypotenuse is squared of 2. So in other words, you could have a bigger triangle or a smaller triangle, but the ratios basically are 1, 1, and square roots of 2. All right, so now, if we look at what's going on for, let's say, sine of 135 degrees, what I do is I find where that is, that's over in quadrant 2, and you always put the triangle down to the x-axis. All right, so we recognize that this is a 45 degree angle right here. Okay, now we know the legs are 1 and 1, but I'm going to actually write a negative number if it's on the negative side of x. So I know the length really isn't negative 1, okay, but I'm going to just write negative 1 there. And then for the y leg, it's up going up, so I'm going to positive 1, and the radius is always going to be positive. That's the only one that I'm going to put as the positive length. So know what I'm what notice what I'm doing. Instead of writing 1 1 square roots of 2, I'm writing negative 1 1 square roots of 2 to designate the cosine over here is going to be negative. So if I want the sine of 135 degrees, we have that the sine also, it's going to be y over r. So we look at the y value, 1 over square roots of 2. Now if I wanted the cosine of 135 degrees, I would want the x, in this case negative 1, over the radius, or the hypotenuse if you want to think of it that way, over square roots of 2. Let's look at another example. Alright, so we want the tangent of negative 405 degrees. First of all, let's see where that is. If I go negative 405 degrees, well, I'm going this direction, right? So all the way around is 360. And so if I go 360, I got 45 more degrees to go, and there it is. It would be that extra part right here. So it's going to be somewhere around here. So now, you know what's over here in quadrant 4? And let's see. For my lengths here, I'm going to put 1 because it's going to the right for the x direction, but for the y, it's a negative 1. And the hypotenuse or radius is going to be square roots of 2 again. So the tangent is going to be the y over the x. So the y is negative 1 and the x is 1. So it's going to be negative 1 over 1, which is negative 1. And so on. So that's a simple way. If you just draw where it is and then label your sides, if it's a 45 degree angle, either 1 or negative 1, depending on if the x or y is positive, where the triangle is. And then for the hypotenuse or radius, if you want to think of it that way, you always put in the square roots of 2. The last special triangle is the 30-60-90 triangle. Again, it's in a previous video that you can see why we get this ratio of sides. But remember that the smallest side, if the smallest side is 1, the hypotenuse is twice as long. So we have 1 for the smallest, 2 for the longest, and for the longer leg of the triangle, we have square roots of 3. So it's 1 squared of 3, 2. Now remember, the longest side is opposite the biggest angle. So the 90 degrees biggest and 2 is the longest side. 30 degrees is the smallest angle, and across from that is the smallest side of 1. So we're going to do the same thing. Let's say we wanted to find the sine of, let's say, 210 degrees. Okay? So I first find out where that is. So I know it's 180 here and 30 more, so I always exaggerate it. So it's easy to say what the biggest side is. So here's the hypotenuse, and so you have to remember the hypotenuse is 2 and the smallest side is 1, but since it's going down here, I'm going to put negative 1, which leaves this other leg to be negative square roots of 3. Again, I'm using these minus signs loosely to get across the idea. I'm just trying to make it simpler. So if I want the sine of 210 degrees, now I look at this, the sine is the y over the hypotenuse or the radius, depending how you want to think of it. So the y value is negative 1. So this is negative 1 over 2, or I could write that as negative 1 half. All right, let's do another one. Let's do the tangent of negative 30 degrees. All right, so we're going to go negative 30. So I'm going to go about this much. Again, notice I exaggerate. So for my y value here, the smallest side is going to be 1, but in this case it's going down. So I'm going to write negative 1 and the hypotenuse is 2, so this is going to be positive square roots of 3 for the x value. And tangent is y over x. So the y value, negative 1 over square roots of 3. Now, that's the correct answer, negative 1 over square roots of 3, but if you did rationalize the denominator, you would multiply top and bottom by square root of 3, and that would be negative square roots of 3 over 3. Okay, so that would, if you rationalize the denominator, otherwise you could write it as negative 1 over the square root of 3. It's just not quite. quite as simplified. All right, so that's my basic easy way. I just always draw triangles. I do not memorize any charts. All I remember is that I'm either going to have something right on the x or y axis, I remember those ordered pairs, or I'm going to have the 45 degree angle, whoops, that was supposed to be square root of 2, or I have the 30, 60, 90 triangle. More problems on the next video.